So the other day, I was in a shop and I heard this conversation between two moms. They complain about the fact that their children prefer watching YouTubers playing on a screen instead of playing with each other. I would like to know if you think that your movie, even just for a little bit, can help this young generation to understand the difference between virtual and real life and maybe find a balance.
No. The truth is, we have been trying to have these conversations with our own children, and we've made an entire movie about it, but it's so complicated, you know? And technology's been like the savior of our children in many ways over the last 18 months, a way to connect and entertain them when they had nothing else. But of course, we're all completely terrified and trying to make the rules up all along as parents. I wanted in the very beginning, I thought that, you know, by making an iPad into an animated character and then having Ron be this funny one that went wrong, it would be like the difference between a puppy and an iPad, right? An iPad is brilliant. It does everything you want. A puppy's really annoying and eats your toys, but which one is more fun? But I don't know. Have we persuaded children?
No.
I think
I
we've
don't
just
think
made them
so.
want BeeBots.
Do you know what? Also, like, I think you've got to you've got to respect children. And you know, I can look at something. My daughter reads this cartoon series called a comic book thing called Lore Olympus, and they're just never ending comic books that you scroll forever and they literally never end. And she will read one of those for like 5 hours. And but I'm not going to criticize, it's not my world. And you know, my younger daughter plays Roblox all the time, and again, it's that's her world, so you
I
know,
know,
we're
and
not judging
also
it.
we put ourselves in the movie because we're criticizing them and saying, "Come on, get out and have some fresh air." And they're like, "But you've been on email for the last 4 hours." So we're all trying to figure this out together.
My kids are trying to limit my screen time.
And I would like to know, how did you develop the incredible character of Donka? She's amazing.
Oh, Pete and I love naughty old people. I think we both had really like badly behaved, eccentric, brilliant grandparents that we loved when we were children. And Eric, so many families have a character like that, some brilliant matriarch, you know, who can kill a chicken and mend the car and
It's
grow
kind of
the
very
vegetables.
un-PC, you know. Like my grandmother used to make me and my brother raw pork sausages. And she just give them a sausage, and like my dad would freak out and go, "You can't give them raw sausages." And she said, "Oh, they're fine. It's okay, you know." And just like cook weird things, like a whole ox tongue. She'd cook at Christmas, and like it's just I think kids love that kind of thing, you
She's
know.
the opposite of
Fond
technology as
memories,
well.
yeah.
She's
We
the
used to love.
opposite of modern technology. That's the idea of her.
My grandmother used to fart a lot as well, and then blame my uncle Jim.
And when you were Barney's age, did you have a special friend with who live adventures?
You know, I think I had both things because I had the experience, as all of us have, of being at school and feeling like everyone had a best friend but me. But I had another friend that I had known from outside school. And so we had the kind of weekend adventures together. So, like everybody, you have a bit of both. You have those moments when it all seems difficult and you feel kind of on your own, and those brilliant moments you remember when you connect with someone.
Yeah, I had like one or two super nerdy best friends just like me. I'm very much that world, you know. I think everyone, you know, you need that.
Thank you so much for your time and
Thank you. You're
congratulations.
welcome.
Thank
Thank you
you.
very much.
Thank you. Bye.
Take care. Have a great day.
You too. Bye bye.